This conference will now be recorded.
So welcome to the day 15 session of data science using Python induction training program. So today we can discuss about one more concept called regular expressions in Python. Okay, so can anyone say what are the things we have discussed in yesterday's class? So what are the things we have seen yesterday? So what are the things we have discussed in yesterday's class? Yes, good. Packages, modules and packages. Okay, so built-in packages by modules. Okay, for the built-in packages and modules, we have seen few different types. Random, one of the modules is the random. Then we on the other day, we have seen about the math. Then we have seen one of the package called random. Then we have seen about so we have seen one more module called OS, which are the predefined packages. After that, we have seen how to create the user defined packages. We have seen how to create the user defined packages. Packages or modules. Okay, I hope everyone got like a clear idea about the how to create user defined packages and how to use the okay, so before going to the concept of regular expressions, let me take a simple string. So similarly, let us take some string. You can take any of the string. So let me copy some amount of string. Okay, I'm creating some multi-line string which contains multiple things. Okay, so if you want to get only the capital characters. Okay, so if you want to get, if a particular character is capital character, I want to extract that particular capital character from this entire string. How I can do? Can anyone help me for extracting the Can anyone help me how to extract a particular capital characters from this group of characters? What is the thing I need to do? If I want to extract a if I want to extract a particular capital characters from a group of characters? So what are the things I need to say? That I need to iterate over the loops, transfers, and check is capital. Convert them to list. Okay. Convert them to list. I am asking here only single character. Yes. One of the practices you can convert to the list. Transfers and check if capital. Use uppercase. Use uppercase. Okay. So good. So what is the thing I need to do? So first of all, I need to either I need to iterate over the loop. Okay, I can iterate over the loop the entire string, or either I can use it to convert that to list. So for example, so I can iterate over the loop, but this is also one way. Like as one of the friends suggest, so I can convert easily. If I pass that particular string to the list class, means automatically each and every character will be separated. Okay, each and every character will be separated, and you can iterate over this particular list, or you can directly iterate over this particular string. Okay, either ways, both that. Both the same, but because string is an iterable, so that no need to convert that particular string to the list. Okay, so because it is some time consuming, so for that purpose, what I'm doing is I'm directly iterating over the let me delete it here and add a few cells. Okay, so I have converted either way. So what is the thing I need to do? First, I need to convert that particular to. So for storing the uppercase characters, I am taking a particular list. For storing the uppercase characters, I am taking a list. So what is the thing I need to do for character in string? Yes. For character in string, yes. What is the thing I need to check? If yes, but is upper. If the particular character is uppercase, if the particular character is uppercase, then what I can do? I can simply append to the Then I can simply append to the list called li lfchi. If I printed outside the loop, means automatically whatever the uppercase characters available, all those things will be connected to the list called li. Okay. So similarly, if I want to get the special characters, there are few different types of special characters available. If I want to separate those special characters, how I can separate? Can anyone help me if I want to separate only the special character from this group of characters? So here special characters are nothing but the slash, dot, semicolon, colon, okay, dot, hyphen. I need to use all those things. I need to extract those particular group of characters. What is the thing I need to do? Mohan, what I need to remove? Okay, I can use this particular same program, or I can use over the another program. So what is the thing I need to do? So here all these things will be common. Simple, I need to modify the condition. Good. Yes, good. Okay, so everyone got the correct answer. Okay, what is the thing I need to check? If a particular character is not an is alum, so now if that particular character is not belongs to either alphabet or number, yes, good. Okay, then I can append to that particular character. If that particular character is an if char, but is if not char. Is alum. Okay, so I can I should iterate over the group of characters. Okay, I have to iterate over the group of characters. Then I have to check whether that particular character is an uppercase character or lowercase character, or so depending upon my extraction. Here, what is nothing but the data extraction. Okay, as a data scientist, what we have to do among the group of data, we need to extract our required data. Okay, here what I am doing here, here we are having the group of data here. Now let us take this is the group of data. So in this group of data, what I am extracting? I am extracting all the special characters. Okay, I am extracting all the special characters. Space is a special character. Colon is a special character. New line is a special character. Hyphen is a special character. Parenthesis is a special character. Okay, so how many times this particular loop will be iterated? How many times this particular loop will be iterated? Can anyone tell me? So can you guess how many times this particular loop will be iterated? Yes. Okay. So how many total number of characters are available? That many times? Yes, good. Okay, that many times this particular loop will be iterated. Exactly. Okay. So if I want to know the how many characters are available nearly. Nearly how many characters are available? Nearly some, sorry. 565 characters are available. Previously also we have taken the same string. There are total of 565 characters available. Total of this loop will be iterated for 565 times and it will extract our required data. Okay. So here what we are doing here, we are extracting our required data. For one thing we have done is that we are extracting our required data. So similarly, if I want to replace this particular special character with the hyphen, none of the special character occurs. For example, my task is to replace all special characters with star star. Okay, I need to replace every special character in the string with the star star. What is the thing I need to do? Can anyone help me? I want to replace each and every special character with the star star. Like if whenever the colon occurs, I need to replace with star star. Whenever the parenthesis occurs, I need to replace with the star star. Yes, first of all, I need to use the replace method. Okay, using replace method, what is the thing I need to do? Other okay, I need to use replace method. Any other things I need to do? For replacing, what are the two required things I need for replacing? I need to know which what are the special characters available. Okay, when are that special characters available, and I can replace with that particular star star. Any other things I need to know? So I am having only present. I am having only the yes. Okay, so I know that when are the special character available. When are the special characters available, I need to replace with them with the star star. Imran, okay, so you are giving the conditions, so nothing much. You are giving the exact logic. So what are the things I need to take? Either I need to declare an empty variable, or either I need to first extract the special characters, or what are the things I need to do? There are many ways of doing a particular problem. As one of your friends suggested, replacing with like you can replace with them with using the method replace. Okay, you are saying that if char not like equal to not is alum, then I can also replace. So for that purpose, what are the thing I need to do? Iterate and check the condition. Okay, so there are two different solutions. Well, let me tell you what are the two different ways I can solve. So you are saying that iterate and check the condition. Okay, good. So first of all, what I need to do is that I need to take an empty string. So because this is a string, already these are group of characters available, then I need to take one more string. That is the one more I am declaring an empty string. Okay, so why I am taking empty string is nothing but if that particular character is not a special character, simply concatenate the characters. Okay, simply concatenate. If that particular string character is a special character, instead of that special character, concatenate with the double star. Now let us see what are the different ways of doing this particular problem. Let me delete. Okay, if he is not there, what I need to do is the s1.s1+= double star. Because it is a special character, simply what I have to do, instead of special character, I need to concatenate with the special double star. Else what I need to do, simply I need to concatenate with the char. Okay, what are the things I have done? So first of all, if the particular character is not a special character, simply concatenate with the double star. If that particular character is a normal character or number, simply concatenate with the character. Okay, now let us see what is happening. Yeah, yes, we no need to take any of the string. Okay, what happened? One of the special character occurred automatically. Instead of the special character, this double star has been concatenated. If you observe, there is a space, it is a special character. I have concatenated with the double star. Okay, again I have concatenated with the double star. Okay. So for example, except space. Except the space, I need to concatenate each and every special character to the double star. What is the other condition I need to include? Accepted a space. Except the space, I need to replace each and every character with the double star. What is the other condition should I include? Yamran, there is no like empty. Compare, good. Yes, I need to use AND operator. And what is the condition here? Yes, char not equal to space. Then I can check whether that particular thing is in char not equal to space. Yes, I can include either that condition or simply instead of using another, including one more condition. Here I can check whether that particular character is not in space. Okay, if that particular character is not in space, then I can use that. I can I'm skipping the concatenating, so it will automatically check, it will automatically the space will be concatenated. Or otherwise, we are having one more method called char dot e space. If you, I think I char dot e space s p s e. So what is the thing I need to do? Not char dot e space. So the easiest way is to comparing with the space not equal to space, or otherwise not char dot e space. What will be happening? Spaces will be eliminated. Whenever the space occurs, the string will be same. Whenever the other characters like hyphen or either hyphen or colon or semicolon, what are the other things available or new line? Remaining will be concatenated with the double star. Okay, remaining will be separated with the double star. Okay, so why I'm saying all those things is like, so if you observe here, these are the different patterns. Okay. So these are the different words. For example, if I want to get all the words which are started with the lowercase. Okay, so here I am extracting some amount of data based on some different conditions. For example, now if I want to get each and every word which is started with the lowercase characters. I want to extract each and every word which is started with the lowercase character. What is the thing I need to do? Can anyone help me? I need to extract each and every word which is started with the lowercase character. Okay, is lower. So here the first letter should be the lower, remaining can be upper or lower, anything, but only the first character should be the lowercase. Remaining can be special characters or anything. If I check only the is lower means automatically, if there are any special character means automatically that word will be eliminated. Not capital. Okay. Any other things? I am saying only the first character. And I am saying the words. What is the thing I need to do? If you want to get the words, okay. So from the string, if you want to get the group of words, from the group of characters, if you want to get the group of words, what is the thing I need to take? Group of words. What is the thing I need to do first? Yes, I want to split the string here. Okay, so I want to split the string. Getting the group of characters, good. Okay, so here what we can do is the first we can iterate over the things. So what is my condition here? If the first character is not an uppercase character, so let me take one more list for getting the yes. Okay, so let me take one more list called li. So if the particular character, if the first character is not an uppercase character, then automatically concatenate that particular word into the list here. Okay, so many of you given so many answers, but most of the answers are nearly correct. Okay, so I am saying here particular, I am saying whether check only the first character. Okay, for getting the first character, as one of your friends Saranthe is suggested. So what is the thing for getting the first character from the word? If you want to get the first character, how I can get the first character from the word? Nothing but the string. Yes, good. Okay, here I have to use the
indexing. So char of 0 dot e 0 here. Good. If char of 0 dot e 0, if that particular first character is a lowercase character, then automatically up concatenate to the or nothing but add to the list called color. Simple. Okay, so if you observe, if I check that entire world, okay, if I check that entire world, so automatically what will be happening? High level will be eliminated, typing semicolon will be eliminated. Okay, so a few characters will be eliminated, like appeared colon will be eliminated. So I said you only to check the first character. Okay, here I said to check only the first character, so you have to check in this form. Okay, so these are the different ways. So here what is happening, but whenever I am saying you to check whether some things, so those are called as the patterns. Okay, so check whether the first character is uppercase or not. Okay, if you want, there are group of row numbers, check whether that particular group of row number belongs to the CSE branch or not. Okay, CSE branch or not. So for checking all those things, it will be somewhat hard for identifying, for building the logics. Okay, for example, there are a group of row numbers. Okay, the secondary row numbers, third year row numbers, final year row numbers, and some other colleges row numbers also combined into a single list. Okay, so if I want to separate the row numbers which are belongs to the CSE means, I need to take each and every row number, I need to separate the row number, and I need to extract the branch code, and I need to check whether that branch whether that particular row number belongs to the CSE or not. Okay, so if for that purpose there is a like it takes some amount of time for building those different types of logics. Instead of that, we can build a something called patterns. Okay, for example, here I am checking whether that if, for example, I hope most of you have used the find in web browsers. Okay, find in web browser. For example, if I want to get the Python. Okay, if I want to search for the Python, if you observe here, whenever I have typed something on the find, automatically, whenever the pattern matches, automatically those are highlighted. Whenever Python occurs, it can be lowercase characters and it can be uppercase characters. Okay, automatically whenever the Python occurs, all those are highlighted. Okay, so it doesn't check whether the first character from the starting hours is it Python or not. Simple, whenever those characters are matched, automatically those things will be highlighted. Okay, so for example, if I want to know the on, if you want to check whether the on is available or not. Okay, here what I'm doing here, I'm filtering or extracting my required data. Okay, on, automatically what will be happening, whenever the on is available, automatically on will be highlighted. Okay, so this is nothing but the regular expression. So regular expression is nothing but the search pattern. Okay, so let us see the what is meant by the regular expression. Okay, regular expressions are nothing but the group of characters. Okay, a group of characters by special characters. There are also few different types of special characters available for some different purposes. I will discuss all those things for matching the pattern. Okay, so what is the thing? A group of characters or special characters for matching a pattern. If you observe here, whenever I search for some pattern, so these two characters are called as a search pattern. Okay, these two characters are called as a search pattern. Okay, so automatically, if you observe in the any of the editors like Word document or Google Docs or Notepad or anything, you can observe the find and replace. Okay, whenever the on occurs, if you want to replace that on with the some other number. Okay, whenever the on occurs, it can be uppercase characters or lowercase characters. Okay, so whenever the on occurs, if you want to replace with the NO. Okay, in that cases, what will be happening is the in background, the same thing, one of the concept will occur is nothing but the regular expressions. Okay, regular expression, so the expression here, nothing but the pattern. Okay, expression is nothing but the pattern. Pattern is nothing but the group of characters. It's a group of characters are called pattern. Okay, for matching, sorry, a group of characters. Okay, group of characters constructed for matching a particular pattern. Okay, now let us see if there are, or now let us see how to use the regular expressions. Okay, now let us see how to use the regular expressions. For there are, like in Perl language or in most of the programming languages also, regular expressions also available. In Python, for using the regular expressions, we are having one of the module called RE. RE is the module available in Python for using the regular expressions or for constructing the regular expression such patterns. Okay, so now we can see how to use the regular expressions. So for the regular expression, so if I want to any of the so for regular expression, for using the regular expressions in Python, we are having a module called RE. If I want to use a module in Python, what is the thing I need to do first? If I want to use a module in Python, what is the thing I need to do first? Yes. Okay, so what is the thing I need to do first? Simple, I need to import RE. I need to use the keyword called import for getting that what for using that particular module. So here, what is the thing? So this is the RE. RE is the module built inside the constructed by the Python code developers. It is a built-in module. Okay, for having the regular expression. So if you want to know the document string, what is the purpose of this particular module? Let me print it here. Okay, so if you observe here, this module provides regular expression matching operations similar to the similar to those found in Perl. Okay, so starting this particular regular expression has been passed in the programming language called Perl. Okay, similar to that, those concepts are also implemented inside the Python in the package for in the module called RE. It supports both 8-bit and Unicode strings. So there is different types of strings available, Unicode strings. Okay, and all those things. So it can support 8-bit or otherwise the Unicode strings. Okay, those are the format of the data. Both the patterns and the string being processed contain null bytes and characters outside the US ASCII range. Okay, so those are that is the description for the regular expression. Can contain both special and ordinary characters. Most ordinary characters like capital A, small a, or zero are the simplest regular expression. They simply match the answers. So you can concatenate ordinary characters. So last match will be the last. Okay, so what it is, so like as I said previously, regular expression is nothing but the group of characters. It can be normal characters or it can be some different, like we can also construct them with the special characters. Okay, so for using the special characters, there are these are the different types of special characters available for using the regular expressions. We can see few of them, most of them we can see in today's class. What is the purpose of a dot in regular expression for the pattern? What is the purpose of cap, dollar, and all those things? Okay, so like these are the all the patterns here. Okay, these are all the patterns we can use. Okay, but while coming to the methods, this module having the we are having module method called match, full match, search, sub and split, find all, find iterator, compile, purge, escape. Okay, so these are the different methods constructed inside the regular expression module. So we can use the today we can see the methods called match, search, okay, sub and split, find all. Okay. So these are the few common methods which are used widely. Okay, so we can use these are the extended method. So if you have created a pattern, so for example, if you want to extract vowels AEIOU or capital AEIOU or small AEIOU. Okay, simply what you can do is you can simply construct a such pattern AEIOU and you can use the ignore case. What will be happening is if that is capital AEIOU or small AEIOU, simply those characters will be extracted. Okay, so you have to use the special character as the I. Okay, I automatically, what will be happening if that particular character is uppercase or lowercase, automatically that character will be extracted. Okay, so like the same things I have added as the tabular format for ease of understanding. So let me show you those things. Okay, so here dot, so if you use the special character as the dot, a paid matches any single character except the new line character. Okay, so accept that new line character for ease of understanding. What we can do is there is one website called REGEX101. Okay, so for constructing the pattern, it is the one of the best way, one of the best website. You can use this particular website. Okay, so for now, what we can see, we can take the same thing which we have taken previously. So let us do what are the operations we have done in simpler ways. Instead of writing the like complex logics, what we can do is the simple, what we can do is a simple search pattern can be written for extracting those things. Okay, so I have taken the same thing and I have printed here. So let us select the Python as the programming language. So Python 2.7 or Python 3, both the things are same for the regular expressions, but actually Python 3 should be available. Okay, no worries. Okay, so if you want to get any of the character, okay, if I want to get each and every, instead of splitting, if I want to get the each and every characters, okay, except the if you want to use the extract each and every character, then simply I can use the dot. Okay, it can be any word. Okay, it can be any character. So why it is the why we are using the dot means we can while building the patterns we can see. Okay, so what is happening? So dot will match each and every character. Okay, so whenever I use the dot as the pattern, it will match each and every character. If you observe, every character has been matched. For the differentiation purpose, they have added the different colors, but every character has been selected. Okay, every character has been selected. Okay, that is the purpose of the first thing is nothing but the dot. Okay, dot will match each and every character. Okay, so here cap is nothing but the starts with. Okay, so if you want to get the characters which are started with the A. Okay, so like if you want to get the characters which are started with the capital P, automatically if I use the dollar P means, sorry, cap P means, automatically those particular things will be matched. Okay, so cap P is nothing but whatever the paragraphs which are started with the capital P, automatically those will be highlighted. Okay, for example, if you want to get capital P, so then if you want to get the any of the character, okay, so with the cap after capital P, I need to get the second character which I started with the capital P. If you want to get the first four characters which are started with the capital B. Okay, if I want to get the four characters, the word should contain total of four characters. Among the four characters, the starting character should be the capital B. What I'm saying here, so highlight all the each and every word which is started with the capital B, then it should have the four characters. For example, preview is having the 4+3=7 characters. Python is having the 6 characters. If I am saying get the 6 characters means automatically the 6 characters will be highlighted. If I am using one more dot means what will be happening is the compulsive that particular string should start with the capital P and it should contain 7 characters. Okay, it should contain the special character because it is a single complete string, so that is it has been automatically highlighted. So if I split this particular thing means automatically it will not be highlighted. Okay, so because it is an entire string, if I split this as the words means automatically more things will be highlighted. Let me split the string into different lines. Okay, I will show you, but here for ease of understanding I'm explaining in this particular thing because how the pattern is working. Okay, for showing you how the pattern is working, I'm showing here. Okay, so entire word starting with P. Okay, entire word with, if you want to get the entire word which is starting with the P means, so you have to use the another thing called star. Let me show you the next character. Okay, so we are having which is nothing but the star here. Automatically, whenever I use the star means 0 or more times. Okay, if you want to get each and every characters which are started with the capital P, and I need to get the each all the characters. Okay, I will explain after some time. So how to select the entire word. Okay, so first thing is that if I want to extract a particular data based on my pattern, here what is my pattern here? Select the word which is started with the capital P. Here what will be happening? Every capital P will be extracted. But for example, if you want to get the first four characters, next four characters, simple I can use the four. Okay, but that is nothing but it will matches each and any character. It can be special character, it can be space, or it can be word, alphabets, or it can be numbers. Okay, so it will be automatically highlighted. For example, if I want to use the same thing inside the Python, Okay, if you want to same thing, if you want to extract the same thing is we are having one method called find all. Okay, so for the methods, the same, the syntax for all the methods is the same. Syntax for all the methods is the same. The syntax is nothing but the method of pattern comma string. Okay, so I will explain the methods, few different types of methods. Okay, so the syntax will be the same. What if I use the method name? So previously I have shown you the what are the methods available. It can be, the method can be match, search, sub and split, find all. I think these things will be, we will be discussing match, full match, search, sub and split, find all. Okay, so the method can be the anything, but the syntax is same. I have to pass the pattern first, then I have to get the string. Okay, simply if you want to get each and every word, first of all let me extract the capital T. Simply what I have to do is the re dot find all of, re dot find all of what is the matching character here, capital T, and what is the wherever our string is located, our string is located at the capital S. Automatically what will be happening is the all the capital P's will be extracted. Okay, all the capital P's has been, will be extracted as I shown you previously. Okay, in the particular website, the particular capital P is highlighted. Okay, if I use the find all means automatically those all the things will be extracted. For example, I want to know what is the character after the capital P. After the different characters are available. See, if you want to get the first two characters after the starting into the capital P. Okay, here I didn't use the starting. So simply what will be happening is the whenever the capital P occurs, automatically the next two characters will be extracted. Okay, here P is the capital, so that is what are the characters available. I have got all those characters. Simply if I want to get the characters which are started with the anything but the whatever the words available with the A dot dot. Okay, A dot dot, automatically what will be happening, each and every word will be extracted. Simply I am not using any of the conditional statements or not. I am here, if you observe here, simply if you want to get the same pattern is I need to use the loops, and I need to check each and every character length. I need to check is the first character is A or not. Okay, inside the string here, not the words. Okay, AN space. Okay, AL hyphen, which is nothing but the, which is this character, where this character has been got is nothing but the, sorry, small s. Okay, in the high level, if you observe here, I think in the high level, general purpose. Okay, so this is the nothing but the, this is the AL minus hyphen. Okay, so it can be anywhere inside the string, automatically those things will be, or nothing but those data will be extracted. Okay, so dot is nothing but it can be any of the character. It can be special character, it can be uppercase, it can be uppercase character, it can be lowercase character, it can be special character. Okay, so dot is nothing but the match any character. So simply what is nothing but the cap. Cap is nothing but the, if that particular word is started with. Okay, simply dot is the same thing is I need to get each and everything which is started with the capital A dot, small a dot dot. Okay, so there is no thing started with the capital small a and two dots. Okay, if you observe here, this is one string. Sorry, this is the one thing. Okay, it checks the line by line. If I use the starts with me, it will check the line by line. Okay, so there is no particular line which is started with the capital A and two dots. So if I want to check the capital P, if a particular line is started with capital P and then get the second two characters and get the next two characters. If you observe here, this particular thing has been started with capital P, then I have got the next two characters. Okay, in the entire string. Okay, in the entire string. Next thing is a slash here. Slash is nothing but it matches the each and every uppercase character. Okay, previously what I have done, I have used the capital P. If you want to get each and every word which is started with the capital or nothing but the, which I extract every word with the capital A, capital character and next two characters. Okay, capital character and next two characters, if you observe here, capital A.
Okay, it will match this only at the starting of the string. If you observe here, it will match this only at the starting of the string. If the particular character is an uppercase character or not. If you observe here, if in the starting we are having the capital B. Okay, so then I have extracted that if a capital B, then I have extracted that capital P single character capital Y. These two characters has been extracted as the capital P1. Okay, capital slash A checks uppercase or not. What is the uppercase? Second starting character is uppercase and next extract the single character. Okay, similarly, so slash A defines the uppercase characters. Simply, next thing is the dollar. It will check whether the matches the end of the string. It matches that particular thing is ending or not. For example, if I want to get the characters which are ending with the capitals A. Okay, so there is no particular word which is ended with the capital A. If you observe here, this string has been ended with the small e. If I want to get the small e means I can get the IV. What I'm doing here, just get the character. If the particular string is been ended with the small e, get the previous two characters. Okay, so that is I have got the I, V, and E. Okay, if you want to get the five characters, we simply have to use the five dots. Four dots and last thing is E. Automatically, that thing will be extracted. Okay, so dot means nothing but the any of the character. Okay, so here we have seen the dot is nothing but any of the character. It matches any of the character. It can be uppercase or lowercase or anything. So cap matches the starting character of the string. Okay, slash is also matches the. Okay, this is the single string. If you observe here, this is the entire single string. This is the entire single string. It is checking the first two characters. So that is I have got the P by T. Okay, so P, so in the inside this particular string, PR is available. Okay, so it will check like this. So if I print the S means, this is the single string. It will consider slash and also and special slash and is also a character inside the string. It doesn't check whether the new line or new string or not. If I pass, if I'm checking the, like, If I'm iterating over the loops, and if I use it, the particular thing means I will be getting PAR also. Okay. So next thing is the slash Z. Slash that is nothing but the uppercase Z matches only at the end of the string. Okay, so which is slash Z is nothing but the if that particular character is uppercase Z or not. Okay, uppercase Z or not at the end of the string. If any of the string contains the capital Z at the end of the string, then it matches. For example, let us take an example of the S P equal to. There is something available, it is ended with the capital Z. Okay, if you want to find the. So dollar checks is the particular thing is ended or not. Okay, slash Z checks the whether that particular character is ended with the uppercase Z or not. Okay, so it will checks the capital Z and it returns the three characters. Other three characters. So that is I have got as the B, VK, BZ. So here why we have got the empty list is nothing but the, so somewhere I have got that. Sir, for dollar showing only empty list. So you have to, like, dollar is nothing but the, whether it is ending with the particular character or not. If that particular string is not matched with the required thing means it will get the empty list. Let me show you here. Okay, actually the string is ended with the reflector, which is nothing but the small e. If I am checking, if I want to get the ending of the thing and get the previous three characters, it will use the empty list because the character string is not ended with the capital E. If it is ended with the capital A, means automatically the previous characters will also be extracted. The previous characters also be extracted. Okay. So which is nothing but this. So for example, if you want to separate this particular string with the 3-3 characters. For example, if I want to convert this entire string to the substrings of 3 characters. Okay, which is nothing but the P by T as one string, HYN as one string, space ISEs as the one string, space AN as the one string. Okay. For example, if you want to convert this entire string as the group of 3-3 characters, simply what I can do is I can use a 3 dots. Automatically, this entire string will be converted as the 3 characters. Okay. For the, if I want to build this as the logic means, it will take like it is somewhat hard because I need to write the logic. I need to iterate power the loop and I need to check. I need to extract the character by character for the 333 and I need to concatenate and I need to append to the list. Okay. Simply if I pass the 3 dot means automatically my entire string will be splitted with the as the 33 characters. PYP, HYN, space IS, space AN, space IN, TER. And like this. Okay. Here dot is nothing but it is matching any character. So here space is also a character. So dot matches the any of the characters. Okay, so we can see remaining things also, then you will understand the purpose. So here square brackets. The square brackets is nothing but it matches the set of characters you specific within it. Okay, so what are the specific characters I have mentioned it? All the characters will be extracted. For example, I need to get each and every characters. Okay, with the small a to z. Okay, small integer. What if you observe here? So small integer is nothing but the get the three any of the characters, and final thing should be the final thing should be between the A to Z. Let me create somewhat different. Okay, so if you get the each and get the separate the characters as the 3-3 characters, but the ending character should be between the A to Z. Okay, dot is nothing but the any of the character. But if you observe here, the last character should be between the A to Z, small a to small z. Okay. So if you observe here, previously I have got the VE closure parenthesis. Okay. Previously, if you observe here, I have got the VE closure parenthesis. And now in this particular list, I didn't got a particular string called VE closure parenthesis because I have restricted extract only the characters between the A to Z. The last character should be the A to Z between the A to Z. Okay, it should be only the between the A to Z. Okay, so for example, if you want to eliminate these spaces, okay, nothing but the, if the particular 3 characters are contained in the spaces, what you can use the first character should be the capital A to Z, sorry, small a to Z. Okay, small a to Z and the remaining things. Okay, in this way, what is happening? So here I have given only the small a to Z, uppercase characters will be eliminated. If you want to get also get the either uppercase characters also no worries, lowercase characters also no worries means what I have to do is the I need to add the capital A to Z. Okay, square brackets are used for storing the group of characters, matching the group of characters. Okay, so what happened here? So the first character should be the between the capital A to Z and small a to Z. The ending character should be the capital A small a to Z. In the between, it can be any character. It can be space, it can be special character, it can be number. What happened automatically? The first character can be the capital A to Z or small a to Z, and the ending character should be the capital A to Z and small a to Z. In the middle character, it can be any character. So dot represents any of the character. So that is what happened here. Whenever in the middle, there can be special characters, hyphen P. Okay, so that is I am getting in this format. Simply, there should not be any of the special characters. Simply extract, get the each and every continuous 3 characters. Okay, get each and every character with the continuous capital A to Z, small a to Z. First character should be the capital letter, second 2 characters can be the any of the characters between small up lower case. Okay, so if the next 2 characters are, if the next 3 characters are containing any of the special character, those 3 characters will be eliminated. Okay, for example, Python is an. So in between Python and is, there is a space. Automatically, what happened? That particular thing is eliminated in this particular format. Okay, here I will be getting continuous things. It can be uppercase A to Z, lowercase A to Z. For example, if you want to get only the like that word should be start with the capital A to Z, So uppercase and the remaining two characters can be the lowercase characters. Okay, with the nothing but these are the words. Okay, with these are the words. Like with the start with the uppercase characters, then next two characters are the lowercase characters.
Okay, is it clear to everyone till now? So patterns. So building the patterns using the square brackets. Of what is the purpose of dot dollar cap? Is it clear to everyone? Okay. Okay. So if I want to match a pattern of slash. For example, if I want to match, if there are a group of data which is related to the financial data. Okay, there is a financial data. If I want to get the money, I hope in the United States currency, the particular string contains the money contains in the dollars. Okay, if I want to use the dollar as the pattern means, then I have to use the slash escape sequence. I hope you remember the escape sequence slash n. Okay, if I use the n means n will be printed. If I use the slash n means automatically what will be happening? Automatically n will be replaced with the new line. So slash is nothing but the backslash is nothing but the escaping the property of the particular pattern. For example, there are dollars available in a particular string. For example, today I received $10 from my boss. Okay, for example, what is the thing available here? If you want to extract the money from this particular string, if you want to extract the money, which is nothing but the money is nothing but the dollar. Okay, for that purpose, what we need to do is the so here I need to extract dollar also. In that case, what I can do is the so for example, dollar is having one property. What is that particular property? So dollar is nothing but the so that property is nothing but the ending with ends with. Okay, instead of that, what we can do is if I want to get that dollar means simply I have to pass the dollar. Dot dot dollar automatically what will be happening is the dot slash dollar. Find all dot 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 slash dollar. It should work. Sorry, I think D I have forgotten. Okay, so what is happening here? If I want to match the particular thing as the dollar means, what I have to do is I have to use the backslash so that previous property. The actual dollar symbol is nothing but the ends with. Dollar property is nothing but the ends with. What will be happening here? Automatically, what will be happening? That property will be escaped with the slash. If I use the dollar, so let me repeat it like this. Okay, so the ending character can be the any character. So here what I'm doing here, dot dollar is nothing but the ending character can be the anything except the previous character. Okay, so dot dollar is nothing but the, so these two things are these two things will be worked as it is. Dot dollar is nothing but the previous character can be the anything. Okay, previous character can be the anything. For example, if I want to get the ending character should be the E. If the ending character is E, then only extract the previous two characters, then I can use in this format. Okay, so dot dollar is nothing but the ending character can be anything, so extract the one more character. So that is I have got the SS. If I use the slash means automatically it is matching for the dollar symbol. Okay, it is matching for the dollar. So that is the property of backslash. Okay, if you want to extract the any of the such patterns, if you want to extract the dots. Okay, if you want to extract the dots means you have to use the slash dot, automatically those dots will be extracted. For example, from the assisting I want to extract the dots. So dot is nothing but the single character. It will extract in each and every single character. Simply, if you want to know how many sentences are available, so each and every sentence will be separated with the dot. So that is what I can do is the slash dot. Automatically, the dots will be extracted. Okay, slash defines the it will remove the actual property. Okay, it will remove the actual property of that particular character in most of the cases. like slash t or slash n or anything. So whenever you are using the slash, those slash means it is defining some new property. Okay, so if you observe here slash w matches any single character, single letter, digit or underscore. Okay, so if I use the slash w means it will be like it will check the all the lowercase characters. Okay, lowercase w which is the theme of the, it will matches the each and every single digit or underscore. Okay, all the characters are the theme of the is alum as well as the underscore. Okay, if I use the slash w, it will matches each and every character. Okay, it will matches underscore and the capital A to Z, small A to Z numbers. Is alum method. Simply taking for is alum, simply I can use the slash w. Automatically, I will be getting all the characters except the A to Z, small A to Z, capital A to Z, zero to nil underscore. If I use the capital W, means it is nothing but the not is alum. Okay, not is alum, which is nothing but the, I will be getting the all the special characters. Okay, here what will be happening? All the special characters will be extracted. Okay, so simply, if you want to get only the numbers. Inside that string, if you want to get only the number, then I can use the slash d. Okay, slash small d represents the what all the numbers from the extract all the numbers from the string. It can be 1,000 characters, it can be 1 lakh characters, it can be 1 million characters. Automatically, it will returns all the things. Okay, slash d represents the all the numbers. If you want to get all the characters except digits, I can use the capital D. I will be getting all the uppercase characters, all the lowercase characters, all the special characters except numbers. Okay, so for example, if you want to get what is the next character of the every number, what is the next character of each and every number, then I can use the dot. Okay, what is the next character? For example, if you want to get the two digit numbers. What are the two digit numbers available? Then I have to use the two times slash d. Automatically, two digit numbers will be extracted. For example, if you want to get the three digit characters. So three digit number, then I have to use the capital small d. Similarly, if I want to get the all the four digit characters, sorry, four digit numbers, I can use the four slash d's. Okay, so if you want to use the five digit, so there is no chance of five digit. So if you want to get the five digit numbers, means I can use the five digits. Okay, so if you observe here, previously I have got the three digit numbers, so 2002, 2002, 2199. Okay, if you want to get only the numbers which are three digit numbers, only the numbers which are three digit numbers, you have to use the dot. It should start with a number and it should end with a number. Okay, so if I use the n means it is not matching because it should start with a number and it will end with the number. In between, it should contain only the three numbers. Okay, so but if you observe here, it is having the four digit number, so that is it is not matching. For example, if I use the n1, if I use the n1 means it is starting with a number, it is ending with a number, it is having the three digit numbers. Okay, so if I use the pattern as like this. Okay, for example, 360 instead 365 3. Instead of zero, I have used the O. Okay, for example, I have forgotten to give the 305. Simply, I have used the 305. Automatically, it will not matches the particular pattern. Okay, so finally, which is the extraction. So square bracket is used for group of numbers. So slash w, we have seen slash small w, slash small w. So next thing is the slash smallest. Smallest is nothing but it matches the spaces, tab spaces. Okay, new lines, it will return the new line, tab space, spaces. If you want to know how many spaces are available, okay, not only for the extraction. So here final is that method, it will return. Okay, it is returning. There are other methods also. Let me discuss after the first we can use the what are the different patterns are available, then we can go with the other things. Okay, so if you want to get the all the spaces, simply have to use the slash W. Okay, we will be getting the slash small s. We will be getting all the spaces, tab spaces, new lines. If you want to accept the data, accept the spaces, a new line as well as the tab spaces, then I can use the capital S. Except those things, I will be getting each and every character.
Okay, so that is the purpose of like smallest extracting the spaces, tab spaces, and new lines. Capital S, which is used for extracting the data, except a smallest, capital S, and special characters. Okay, everyone following me? Everyone and like everyone understanding how these patterns are working? Please once respond in the chat box. Is it clear to everyone till now? I am expecting responses from most of the students. If it is okay, yes. If any at a point of time it is, if you didn't understand me, let me know. I will try to explain once again. Okay, so here, which is nothing but the smallest is nothing but it will extract the characters, only the spaces, tab spaces, new lines. If I use the capital S space, except the remaining things, which is nothing but the not space. Okay, it is not E space, it is E space, the string methods. Okay, so we have seen those things. So next we can see what is the next pattern. So we have seen the small d and capital D. Small d is nothing but the digits 0 to 9. Capital D is nothing but the except digits. Okay, slash t for matching the tab spaces, slash r for matching the new lines. Okay, so so smaller returns. What is this? Okay, smaller matches the return. Okay, so it returns the matches. So slash b returns only the beginning or ending of the word. Okay, so lowercase b matches only the beginning or ending of the word, which is nothing but the end string. So this is nothing but the I can use slash b for matching either that particular string. What are the strings are ended with the uppercase characters or lowercase characters, it can be anything. So let us take one more thing. So I think I'm having a string called D. Okay, so here what is the thing means I need to extract all the things. So cap small b, which is I need to get any character. Okay, it should end with the any of the characters. Sorry, D. Slash t matches only the beginning or ending of the word. Okay, so I need to check once the slasher versus the slash b. Okay, I will get back after. Okay, plus is nothing but the any of the character. Okay, plus is nothing but the. So if you observe here, let me show you the plus once. I will show you the definition. So plus star. Let me check the plus and star. What is the purpose? Check if the preceding character appears one or more times. Okay, if that particular character is available for one or more times. Okay, it should at least present for one time. Okay, next thing is nothing but the x appears for zero or more times. Okay, so star is nothing but the zero or more times. Plus is nothing but it should at least at least available for one time. Okay, I will show you. Okay, question mark is nothing but the character zero or more times. Okay, it should at least present zero times or one time, only for one time. The pattern should work for only for one time or many times. Okay, only one time or zero times. So plus is nothing but the one or more times. Star is nothing but the zero or more times. Star is question mark is nothing but the zero or one time. So let me show you what is the purpose. Okay, so let me show you. So insert the D. So insert the yes, what I need to do is the star. So that particular character should be captured for one or more time. capital P should append for one or more terms, then only extract the particular characters. Okay, so if you observe here, see when are the capital P occur, automatically that thing will be extracted. If that particular P is not available, automatically the words will not be written. Okay, it checks each and every word, each and every single word. Okay, it checks when are the space after, it will be separated. Okay, so here star checks for each and every word. When are the capital P occurs, automatically extract the word. If you want to know the dot, any character, one or more terms, what will be happening? One or more terms, any of the dot is nothing but any characters, it can be available, one or more terms. Okay, so when are the star occurs means each and every one, the capital P should available for one or more terms, then only extract the thing. If capital P is available for one or more terms, extract the thing. So now capital P, any character can be available for one or more terms, or otherwise any of the digit can be available for one or more terms. Okay, so any digit should be capital, it should be start with the capital P. So star is nothing but the, as I said previously, star is nothing but the, it should be available for, let me show you. Okay, so star is nothing but the, so it should be available for zero or more terms. But while coming to the plus is nothing but the, it should be available for one or more terms. Okay, for example, let me show you the exact definition here. So if I am having a mobile number or otherwise the email ID. Okay, so what is the thing I need to do is that, so here extract each and every, so here I need to extract the English words. Okay, here I need to extract the alphabets. Okay, so for that purpose, what I can do is that, so here how many times I need to write is that, for each and every character, I need to pass the, for example, if I want to, email, for search for the email. So what is the thing I need to do is, here is nothing but the 8-digit. If I use the A to Z means automatically what will be happening is there each and every single character will be extracted. Okay, each and every single character will be extracted. For example, if I use the star means automatically what will be happening is the GR more terms, which is that Anil Kumar will be available, T will be available, APSSTC will be available, and IN will be extracted. Okay, when are the special character, when are the pattern, if this particular pattern did not match as means automatically it will return as the empty string. Okay. So if you observe here, Anil Kumar, so when are the underscore occurs, it has been extracted the empty string. The next iterate, it had extracted the empty string, APSSDC, and all those things. Okay, if I use the, if I included the underscore means, I can also get the, for example, if I use the, if I included the underscore, okay, small iteration and also get the underscore. Then I will be getting the Anil Kumar underscore P is the, which is nothing but the username. APSSTC is nothing but the domain name. IN is nothing but the extension. Okay. Start. Okay. So here, if I use the plus, star is nothing but one or more times. Sorry, zero or more times. If I use the plus, means it should occur at least one or more times. Then only those things will be extracted. If I remove the underscore means you will understand the clear definition. Okay, so here that thing mother, here it should be extracted for one or more times, it should at least available for one or more times. So here previously observed here zero or more times, so that is I have got the empty strings, because zero it is not available, so that is why it has been accepted as the empty string. But here what I am saying here, plus is nothing but the one or more times, this pattern should be available for one time or more times. Okay, so that is why, so here after that, after Anil Kumar, so after Anil Kumar, instead of checking the underscore, so here underscore, I didn't got underscore, it is not having the one or more terms, so that is why it is not extract. Okay, simply. Okay, so if you want to extract the domain names also, what are the characters I have included inside the square brackets, all the brackets will be matches. Okay, similarly, if I use the question mark, question mark is nothing but 0 or 1 term, only 1 term. Only 2 characters will be matches. It can be 0 term or it can be 1 term. Okay, so that is it is checking for each and every, it has been extracted as a single character. Okay, so single character, if it is not a special character, it has extracted as the empty strings. Okay, 0 term or more terms. So 0 or more, 1 or, sorry, here 0 or 1 time only. It will matches only for 1 time. Okay, if I want to get the next character, then I can use the dot. Extract the alphabet and next extract the single character. So that is how I will be getting the 2 characters. Okay, that is nothing but any of the character. Okay, for example, next character should be only the small integer. Okay, extract each and every character. First character should be the small integer. It can be available for 0 or more terms. So extract next character as the small integer. So that is why in the purpose I will be getting each. Okay. So here it is checking. So here actually I should get 2 characters. And here as I use the question mark, it is nothing but the 0 or more. Okay, so 0 or more, which is nothing but it is matching or not, it will matches to the second pair. Okay, so here 1 or more, which is nothing but the infinite times, 0 or more, infinite times, 0 or 1, only for 1 term. Okay, for example, if you want to match for group of numbers. Okay, if you want to match for group of numbers, in that case, I can use the parentheses, flower brackets. Okay, flower brackets will give me the extract. If you want to get all the alphabets, each and every character should be between the two, at least 2 characters, maximum 5 characters. Okay, it should match extract all the alphabets which are having the minimum of 2 characters and maximum of 3 characters. Okay, it is matching for every entire string. So if you observe here previously how many characters are I'm having, so let me use the sum particular string. Okay, it should have minimum of 2 characters and maximum of 5 characters. Okay, it should have minimum of 2 characters and maximum of 5 characters. Okay, so let me have. So if I am having the string as the email, so then automatically it will completely matches. Minimum of 3 characters. Okay, so here first character defines the minimum 2 characters. Next, let us see the 3 characters. It should have minimum of 2 characters, maximum of 3 characters. But it is returning an application. Okay, so flower brackets uses for the matching for the minimum and maximum characters. Create checks for an explicit number of times. Okay, explicit number of times. Okay, so I these patterns, while constructing patterns, you will feel somewhat bored, but applications, let me take an application as if I am working as an network engineer. Okay, if I'm working as a system admin, so here I should work on the if I'm a system admin. Okay, system admin, there are 60 different systems available. Okay, so I want to know whether a particular system is hacked or not. Okay, whether I need to know whether my particular system is hacked or not. Okay, as a network admins, most of the network admins use the regular expressions for identifying a particular for so many purposes. Okay, for now let us check whether a particular system is hacked or not. Okay, if you are familiar with the IP addresses, okay, if any of the unknown IP address available inside that particular network, we can say that unknown user has been accessed the particular system. Okay, so network addresses, I hope if you are familiar with the IP addresses, means it is having the 4 octets. So 163. Let us take as the 125.255. Last character is the last is nothing but the network address. It will be from 0 to 255. Okay. For example, what is the nothing but the, so this is an IP address. So if there are 60 systems, the common things will be, the first is these all the numbers will be the common numbers. Last word will be the, or nothing but the last three digits will be the modified. It will be modified from 0 to 255. Okay. If there is a huge amount of data, like from the 60 systems, I will be getting some 60 different types of IP addresses. Okay. So if unknown IP address is available inside my network, okay, if unknown IP address, for example, unknown IP address is nothing but 172.160.255.255. Okay. So if I want to check whether that particular system is hacked or not, which particular system, or whether in my network is there, but any of the unknown user has been accessible network or not. Okay. For that purpose, instead of taking each and every, as a human being, we can't sit aside and we can't verify each and every IP addresses. Okay. For that purpose, what I can do is I can create a pattern. What is the pattern here? The first eight characters will be the common characters. Okay, so here what is the thing I need to check? The first thing will be the common thing. There are two different IP addresses. So re.match. Here I need to use the one more thing called match. Okay, so match is nothing but it will match from the starting onwards. The next three characters should be any of the digits. Okay, it can be any of the digits from the 0 to 255. Okay, so 0 to 9. Okay, or nothing but the, so for example, so here 0 to 2. So because that network address will be from 0 to 255, 0 to 5 and 0 to 5. And if I pass the IP, okay, match will matches from the starting onwards, whether the particular match has been done or not. Okay, total of I'm having 15 characters, it has been automatically matched the total of 15 characters. Okay, if I pass the IP to me, it will not be matches because it has been different IP address. So that is, it will not match for, so it will return the none. If it is not matching me, simply it will return the none. If it is matching me, we will be getting a match object. Okay. So if I will be getting a match object, if you want to know, if you want to get one, so let me not know, OBJ. I'm getting a match object. If you want to know from which character, which characters it has been. Span is nothing but from the 0th character to the last 15 character, it has been matched. From the 0 character to, in this thing, from the 0 character to last character, this entire pattern has been matched. That is nothing but the span. Okay, if I want to get the span, simply I can call the span automatically. I will be getting a tuple. Okay, if I want to get from which character that particular pattern has been matched. Okay, so if you observe here, this thing should be started. If it didn't use it, the starting and ending, so let me take one more IP address, you will observe them. Okay, so IP3 equal to simple as it is, it is clear that. What will be happening is the instead of I have written it I have written as so here I'm matching first 15 characters. If you observe here, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, I'm matching this particular pattern to my particular string. So this particular pattern has been matched till 15 characters, first 15 characters. So that is how I got as a span as the 0 to 15. Now let us check. Okay, actually, if you observe here, this IP has been matched to the first 15 characters. But is this particular IP is a valid IP address according to my requirement? Is this particular IP address is a valid IP address according to my pattern? According to my requirement, not pattern. Okay, according to my requirement, it is not an actual thing. So for that purpose, what we have to do is that it should started with the, I need to use the IP3. Sorry. Okay, so if I use the IP3 also, it has been matched the IP address. If match object is nothing but the, what are the matching characters? So for that purpose, you should remember to use the starts with and ends with. It should add, it should end at this particular character. Okay, it should end with that particular character. If I use the IP3 means, if you observe here, I have got the output as the null. Okay. In that case, what I have to do is actually I have to use the whether that particular string should be started with the cap. Sorry, I think previously I have added the dollar, forgotly. Okay. Now what will be happening is the it will be start, it will be checking from the starting and it will be end, it will be checking till to the ending. Okay, IP3 is an invalid IP address, IP is a valid IP address. Does the match? Wait a second. If you want to get what is the matching object or what are the matching characters. Okay, simply if you observe here. For the IP3, if you observe here, it is ended with this alphabets. It is ended with the alphabets, but I need to end with this particular number. Okay, it should end the 163.255.255. And it should be between 255 and it should end it. IP address should be ended, so that is I have got the output as the null. I have got the output as the null because it is not satisfying my requirement. But for the IP address, what will be happening is it is matching my requirement, so that is I have got the output as the 0 to 15 from the 0 to first 0 to 15 characters, it has been matched. Okay, so 0 to 15 is not in valid, sorry, not in fixed positions. So depending upon our matter, here I'm matching the 15 characters, so that is it is checking. Okay. So for example, if you want to check whether a particular number, mobile number is valid or not. Okay. If you want to check whether mobile number is valid or not. Previously we have written a program for checking or verifying if a particular mobile number is valid or not. Okay. For that purpose also we can use. So for that purpose, what you can do is that, so if you want to check whether a particular mobile number is valid or not, what are the conditions? What are the conditions? Anyone remember? If a particular mobile number should be an Indian valid mobile number. Valid Indian mobile number. What are the conditions? Anyone remember? For a valid Indian mobile number. Okay. It should start with the plus 91. Good. It should start with the 656789. And it should contain 10 digits. Good. These are the three conditions. Simply, instead of using the different conditions, if you want to search, if you want to extract a particular mobile number is valid or not. For example, let us take as the M1. Okay, yes, it should not contain any of the alphabets, only the number should contain. Okay, for example, first of all, let us match this particular pattern. Okay, if I want to get a particular, if I want to extract from the group of mobile numbers, if you want to accept the numbers, means if you want to verify particular mobile number is valid or not. There are two different mobile numbers. So what is the thing I need to check? So here RE dot match of. Let me declare these two variables here. So now let us see here. So RE dot match of. Okay, so here how I can build the logic. So let me build the pattern first. Pattern equal to, so what should be the first character? So here square bracket is nothing but from the group of characters, the first character should be available. It should started with. Okay, starts with is nothing but a gap, and it should start with the 6, 7, 8, 10. Okay, the second characters can be from between the 0 to 9, or nothing but the slash D. How many characters? It should be the at least of 9 characters, and it should end. Okay, so what is the thing I'm saying? First the character should be the 6, 8, 6, 7, 8, 9, and next I need is here, which is nothing but the here square parenthesis is nothing but the how many times previous character should be available. So there should be at least of 9 digits, because first digit is the available. First digit 1 and next should be the 9 numbers, and it should end. Then it is a valid mobile number. For example, if I'm taking another mobile number, 98. Instead of 0, pressing the 0, what I have done is that I have inserted the O. Okay, this is the pattern. Okay, so if I want to check miss, for example, so I read dot match of pattern, comma, what is the thing I need to do here? I need to pass the M1. So that is matching means I will be getting a match object. If it is not matching means I will not be getting the output. For example, I can also use the print of M2, M3. Okay, M3 and M2 are not following the pattern, so that is I will be getting as the number. Okay, so how I have checked, the first character should be between 6, 7, 8, 9, and in the between I need to get the 8 digits. Okay, so if you observe here, the first character starts with the 3, so that is it is not extracted. And here the ending character is the O, so that is why it has been eliminated. The pattern 3 has been not matched. So that is I have got the output as the false. I have got the output as the none. Okay, so if I want to extract, for example, it is also valid in the mobile number, M4 equal to +91. Now, can you build the logic for this particular thing? Okay, now help me to build this pattern for this particular mobile number, for matching this particular mobile number. Observe the previous things and next that, and let me know how to build this particular pattern. How to build the pattern. Okay, for matching the country code also. What is the modification I need to do for the above pattern? Imran, you have given nearly correct. Can anyone remaining? Okay. It should be started with the, so only it will check only for the first character. If you use the square brackets means it will only check for the single character, first character. Any others? So just try if you want to get this particular mobile number as the valid mobile number. Chetan, you have given correctly near, so small mistake you had done. Snehavali, you also given the correct but small modification. Remaining, anyone trying? Or if you're trying means I will give you one more minute. Let me give you one more minute. It is 6:06. I will give you one more minute. Okay, Imran. I will verify all our patterns, then you will be getting where you have done the mistake. Let me execute the first pattern.
like whatever the Chetan given plus 9 1 7. Yes. Sneha will correct. Now let us see what is happening if I use this particular pattern. Okay. Okay. Start. If you use the stats, it means it will check for the starting character. It is not. Let us check. So re dot match of pattern. Okay, pattern comma m4. Okay. So here, if you observe here, if you are using the cap miss, it should be at the starting character. You can't use the starting character in the between of the start switch in the between of the pattern. Okay, you can't use the start switch in the between of the pattern. You should add at the starting of itself. Okay. Yes, Lakshmi. Lakshmi Likita. Good. Okay. So now let us see the what is the correct pattern. So which is nothing but the, so what is the pattern I need to do here? So what is the thing here? It should be started with the plus 9 1. Okay, it should definitely start with the plus 9 1. Then that's next character should be the next character is between the 0 to 9. Sorry, 6 7 8 9. Then next character should be the digits. Simple pattern equal to it should start with start is nothing but the cap. It should start with plus 9 1. Then the next character should be the between the 6 7 8 9. Then the next character should be the digits. Only the numbers. How many numbers I need to get? 9 numbers I need. Okay, array dot match of pattern comma m4. Okay, for the start with the digit, I have to provide only the first character, I think so. Okay, to that particular number, if this pattern, so for this pattern, so here, it should start with the plus, it should definitely start with the plus, then next two characters should be the 9 1, then next character should be between the 6 7 8 9, and the next character should be the 9 digits. Okay, if any of the alphabet laid between any of the things, so if M3 equal to plus 9 1, okay, next thing also 6. If it is having 11 digits or anything, it will automatically fail. The pattern will automatically fail. It will return the null. Array dot match of pattern comma m3. Okay, it will automatically return the null. Okay, you can also like you can also execute if none is nothing but the false. If something will gives me the 2, okay. If something will gives me the 2, if none, it will be false. Okay. If none is nothing but the false, you can use the like you can use this particular pattern in the conditions. If that particular is valid, means you can say that particular number is a valid mobile number. Okay. So now what you have to do is you have to now you have to create a pattern for get extract in the valid Gmail accounts. Okay, you have to verify if a particular email ID is a valid Gmail mobile email ID or nothing but the valid email ID. Okay, so what are the email ID contents? What are the things available inside the email ID? Can anyone say? Can anyone help me? What are the things available inside the email ID? Okay, this is the task. Let me give you the task. So give the task. Let me give you the task. So A to Z characters, okay, good. Yes, str@gmail.com, good. Okay, so actually username, so how the user, so how the alphabet comma @numbers.com, okay. Okay, actually, if anyone asks the, what is the email contents, okay? You could not say alphabets or numbers or anything, simply username, @domain dot extension. Okay, you are saying for only for the specific Gmail. So your college is also having the like our college. So if you are from SRM University, srm.ap.in, I think so. ap.edu.in or srm.edu.in. Okay, if your college is having the email IDs, okay, like the extensions will be the different. Okay, so here domain is nothing but the company name, extension is nothing but the it will mostly the country. .in belongs to the India. .us belongs to the United States. .aus belongs to the Australia. Okay, so depending upon the country, the extension will be the different. Yes, good, Subhash. Okay, here domain name is nothing but the company name. Gmail, okay, Hotmail, or Yahoo, or Tech Mahindra, or TCS, or APSSDC, okay, or any of the company. Okay, so and first thing is the username. First thing contains the username. Username is nothing but the, so what are the name it having? Okay, name it is having, it is called as the username. So we are having few more minutes left. Okay, so I will be giving the what are the conditions for username contents. So username conditions for, so you have to consider the pattern based on my requirement. Okay, if you observe here, if you entered in any of the application on online applications or nothing but the while filling the Google form, if you enter the email ID incorrectly, means it will automatically gives the invalid email ID. Okay, how it will be checking is nothing but the, so here a username should can contains capital A to Z, small a to Z, sorry, capital A to Z, small a to Z, 0 to 9. Okay, if it is that, if that particular if it is, for example, let us take it as the Gmail. So Gmail can contains a, Gmail can contains the dot. Okay, it should not start with, it should not start with either dot or 0 to 9. Okay, dot or 0 to 9. Okay, what are the minimum characters? So special characters, only dot is available for the username. Okay, only dot. Okay, depending upon the like company, they will be having some requirements. While coming to the APSSDC, APSSDC will also uses the underscore. My email ID contains the underscore. Okay, not only username, not only for APSDC, if this pattern should work for any of the email IDs. Okay, so next thing is, it should not start with the dot. It should not start with dot itself. Few company email IDs will start with the numbers. For example, we are having another domain, so with the your roll number. For example, few college is having that college roll numbers with the starting college email IDs with the roll number. Roll number at the college domain dot extension. Okay, it should not start with the dot. And the minimum characters, minimum 8 characters, maximum 15 characters. Okay, so here username should contain at least of minimum of 8 characters and maximum of 15 characters. That is the thing for the domain name, username. So next it should contain the address. Next it should contain the domain name. For the domain name, let us take the, so minimum of it, also it also can contain the 0 to 9 A to Z. Only there should not be enough the dots. Mostly no company will having the dots. Okay, Tech Mahindra or TCS or anything, it can be the company name, how much it will be, there will not be any of the dots. Okay, so some companies like W3 schools, okay, the domain name is W3 school, so it is having some number. Okay, so for that purpose I have included for the domain name as a 0 to 9. So next it should contain minimum of two characters and maximum of 10 characters. Okay, it can contain maximum of 2 characters and max. So if you observe the domain name of AP government, ap.gov.in, simple, ap.gov.in is the government website. So AP is the username, gov is the extension, government website, .in is the Indian government. Okay, so domain name should contain minimum of 2 characters and maximum of 10 characters, because Tech Mahindra, TECH MAHINDRA. okay, depending upon the thing you can extend. So next thing is the extension. Okay, extension should can contain the 0 to 9, sorry, A to Z, capital A to Z. Okay, so some people will write the domain names as the small letters or capital letters. Okay, so in so only from the minimum of 2 characters, 2 to the 5 characters, .com, dot in. Okay, so dot com, dot in, dot gov, dot us. Okay, so depending upon the taxation will be different. Few company website, there are also some website dot co dot in, dot like dot gov dot in. Okay, that gov dot in mail will be somewhat complete extension. Okay, so that is a special case. You have to build that special case also. Okay, everyone understood how to construct the pattern. So using these things, you have to build a pattern for matching if a particular email ID is valid email ID or not. Okay, tomorrow you should submit the, like tomorrow you can show me, you can send me the pattern into the chat box. So everyone should try to build this particular pattern. Okay. So till now we have seen the find all method. Second method is the match. Now we can see the sub. Sub is nothing but replace. Sub is nothing but the replace the syntax is nothing but the sub. It will takes the new pattern. So what is the matching pattern? What should be the replace thing and the new thing? Okay, what is the pattern here? If the pattern is matches, what is the thing I need to replace? Previously, I haven't shown you. Whenever the special character occurs, automatically replace with the double star. Whenever the special character is available, replace with the double star. In that case, what you have done, I have used the two different conditions. I have initialized a variable. For example, let me show you wherever I have written that. What is happening here? I have initialized a variable and I have checked the two different conditions. I have iterated about the each and every character. Simply, if I use the subband, whenever the special character occurs, or nothing but whenever the space occurs. For example, whenever the space occurs, re dot sub of whenever the space occurs. For the space, I hope you remember smallest. Replace them with the hyphen and the string. Okay, whenever the space occurs, automatically it will be replaced with the hyphen. Okay, not only that, whenever the number occurs. Okay, it is also similar to the string replace. If you observe the previous thing, it is similar to the string replace. For example, whenever the number occurs, replace with zero. Okay, whenever a number occurs, if I want to replace with the zero means automatically whenever the number occurs 3.5, automatically it will be replaced with the zero. Okay, so number occurs, it will be automatically replaced with the zero. If you want to use this same thing means I have to build the logic. If the particular character is between 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I have to use the membership operator and I have to check whether that particular character is inside that character or not, and if this character is inside that character, concatenate zero. But simple pattern, sub automatically replace the particular pattern. So mostly the same thing will be applicable on the document replace, find and replace. Okay, I hope you have used the find and replace in Google Docs or Microsoft Docs documents or anything other notepad or any of the other things. Okay, find and replace, find the character, replace with the new characters. Next thing, we are having the sub and, which returns the how many characters that has been replaced. Okay, how many characters that will be replaced. So which is the thing, 30 different digits are available, the replacement has been occurred. Okay, 30 times the replacement is occurred, 30 returns. Okay, sub done, n returns the, which is the thing, how many times replace has been occurred, n returns. Okay, so 30 times that replacement has been done. That is the purpose of sub n. Okay, so simply if you want to replace all the special characters with the double star, and replace with all the special characters, it can be any of the special characters. Slash w, replace with the star. Slash w is nothing but the except alum, is not alum. Okay, similarly if you want to replace all the things except space, replace all the characters with the star. Okay, except space,
replace each and everything with the star star star. Automatically each and every character will be replaced with the star star. Simply if I use the single star means you will get how many different characters are available. Okay, Python. Okay, first the word is the Python, then it has been replaced with the six stars, next space, next is, next space, and space, high level interpreted programming language. Okay. So in that way, every character has been replaced with the requirement. If you want to know how many times that character or how many characters are available? How many non-space alphabets are available or non-space characters are available? Simply I can use the L. Automatically, what will be happening? 492 characters are available except space. Okay, it is, doesn't count the space because 492 characters has been replaced with the stars. Okay, capital slash capital is nothing but the tab space space new line. Okay, simply if you want to replace every vowel, if you want to replace every vowel with the AEI value, simply replace vowel with the replace vowels with the star. When the vowel appears, automatically it will be replaced with the star. Okay, subband returns how many vowels are available. For example, 163 vowels are available. If you observe here, only the capital vowels are replicated. Only the small lowercase vowels are replaced. Okay, so here if you inserted the cap inside the square brackets, if you insert the cap inside the square brackets, what will be happening is that except the small lowercase vowels, replace every character with the star. Except lowercase vowels. Star is nothing but not these characters. If you remove the cap means automatically what will be happening in when are the vowel occurred, automatically it will be replaced with the star. Okay, if that particular character is a vowel, neglect. If that particular character is not an vowel, replace with the star. Okay, whenever the vowel occurred, it has been replaced. Okay, so if I want to include the space, okay, whenever the space also occur, I can include the space inside that. Automatically the space will be eliminated by replacing. Okay, so whatever the characters I have included, everything will be extracted. So these things will be very helpful while extracting the required data. Okay, while extracting the required data, these things will be very helpful. You should remember all the factors. Okay, if you done some practice means like I will also add few different tasks, then you will be I will add few different types of tasks inside the problems repository using the regular expressions. Then you can identify in which cases so I can use for email verification. Sorry, like for verifying the email ID, phone number, okay, country name, okay, everything, for everything, backend regular expressions taken place in the web applications. Okay, similarly we can use for getting, for extracting the websites. If there is a huge amount of data, okay, if you want to extract all the websites, I can also use the which is nothing but the patterns. Okay, I hope everyone know every website will start with the HTTPS. So next I can have any of the characters extract all those things. Simply have to build a pattern in such a way. Okay, so is it clear to everyone? Purpose of regular expressions and how to use the regular expressions. Data cleaning process, mostly for the data cleaning process. Okay, so unknown characters, if I want to remove them, so I can use this particular things. Okay, data cleaning, mostly data cleaning. Okay, previously we have seen the strip. Okay, strip method only checks for the starting and ending character. Okay, in the between. Okay, if you want to remove all the special characters between means, I can use the regular expressions. Remaining. Okay, everyone should try to complete this task at any point of time. If you are having any doubt means, you can ask me on the Slack channel. Okay, anyone done in yesterday's task like contact application? Anyone tried or anyone completed contact application? Okay, I have got only two responses remaining. Is it clear? What are the things I have discussed till now? So today I have discussed about the one of the thing called regular expressions, in which cases we will be using extracting the or matching or extract the data depending upon the pattern matching. Okay, so these are the different special characters are available. These are the special characters are available. So these are the methods: find, all, match. Okay, subband. So you can explore the what is the purpose of remaining things: find, Okay, and remaining methods we can access. Okay, these are the methods which we will be using in the data cleaning concept. Okay, so that's it for today. Okay, so if you are having any doubts, means you can stay back and ask. Okay, if you are having any doubts, means you can stay back and ask after completing a class while practicing. If you are having any doubt, means so you can ask on the Slack channel. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you for being with us in the day 15 session of data science using Python internship training program. If you are having any doubts, means you can stay back and ask. Otherwise, we can tomorrow we can discuss the remaining concepts.